Trot Joseph Lee, candidate for city council. Tell us why you think you should be elected.
First, I just want to thank the Herald News for the 2015 endorsement, and thank you very much for that. I'm here with the same exact reasons as the previous time that I came here. I truly care about the city. I care about its safety, its education, its economic situation. But I'm running for city council because I also know and feel that there's been a lot of discourse among the government and the direction that we need to go as a city. And I feel as though we need to put the people first. Every single message that I've ever talked about, it's been very consistent with keeping the people as its primary focus, not just taxpayers, but the people that live here, that want to move here, or anything like that at all. Our government has to show that it's competent, has to show that it knows what it's doing, and especially in passing budgets and laws and ordinances, but also keeping the people in mind when they do these things. I think it's the most important factor in all of this. If you've asked the questions, what's the most important element, whether it's economic development, crime, why would we pick one over the other? They're all important. But the people are the most important element. So as a city councilor, I hope, to be able to be a liaison between the people and the government, and particularly going to every single neighborhood association meeting I can go to, paying attention to all the other miscellaneous meetings that all matter as far as how the sewer rates are going, how our real estate situation is going. I'm going to be as engaged as possible and set the example as to why I believe our people should be just as engaged.
Trot, how do you engage people that don't watch city council meetings, that don't vote, they do care, obviously, right, about issues, but right, how do you engage them?
2014, to give you a perfect example. I would first say to them, always look over your shoulder. If you're not going to pay attention to politics, then always look over your shoulder, because the next fee is going to come down the line if you're not paying attention. The purple bag is going to come around the corner if you don't pay attention. So I would let them understand the importance of why we need to be engaged. But the number one importance is that our government does not function unless its people actually care and are engaged. If we allow politicians with self-interest, if we allow anyone with self-interest to get involved in a political process, then it's only going to benefit them. We have to worry about the fact that our people, the people that we care about in the city, need to be the ones in control, the ones that care about what's going on, the ones that pay attention to how budgets are passed, who's voting yes and no to certain things, who has an agenda when they walk in the door, when they go to a council meeting, or if they go into a meeting for anything. What is their agenda? Are they trying to self-promote? Are they trying to promote the city? Are they trying to make things safer? Are they trying to make the education department better? How? You know, I think those are very important things, very important things. And I've gone to every council meeting I've gone to. If you see me in the crowd at all, I'm hanging on every single thing people are saying because it matters, and it really does. We don't have the city we have without engagement from the people.
The current council, in many cases, sort of falls into this 6-3 vote.
Yeah.
We're pretty close to that. So how do you think you can remain independent of falling into a group that is either supportive or against whoever the mayor may be?
Well, that's the word agenda. I just mentioned that, and I saw you, Willie, wrote it down as soon as I said the word, because it's that's exactly what it's about. What is your agenda? Are you trying to oppose you've seen me in both situations where I've been very unsupportive of a mayor, such as Will Flanagan, for example, and where I've agreed with some of the things that Jaisal Correa has done. In both situations, you still got to be neutral and honest to yourself. You can't sway one way or the other based on what you like about that person. You got to look at the policy, and is it going to be beneficial to the city? That's what's really important. So I'll give you an example of currently with this current mayor. Didn't agree with every detail of the streetscapes. Didn't agree with his choice for the drug czar. As a matter of fact, there's record of it because I was at Citizens Input for that. But still agreed with some of the other, factors that he's done over the past couple of years. You just have to gauge every political situation, every policy, and give it your honest, opinion, and push all that other stuff to the side. Stop running for mayor when you're a city councilor. Just be a city council. I don't mean don't run officially, but don't campaign from your seat. You know what I'm saying? If you're just because you oppose the mayor in a political forum for election, don't bring that over to the seat. If you agree with something, agree with it. I think people are going to be more receptive to your honesty and your sincerity than any kind of political ploy that you're trying to pull off from the seat.
What would be some of your goals as a city councilman?
Just in the beginning, what he said, I'd like to. There is an actual official liaison position that between neighborhood associations and city council. So I'd like to be a liaison between those two. I'd like to be involved. I don't know if I want to head, because I think that I think the people who are already ahead of these subcommittees are very likely going to remain. But I'd like to be a part of the ordinances committee. And I'd like to see if they're going to still continue the audits and budget preparation, because even though I didn't think that the council utilized that committee very well at the time, I think it has potential to be productive if we use it in a productive way.
What did you take from your campaign 2 years ago that has changed what you're doing this time around, if anything?
So I believe most of my, I hate to use the term, but my recognition came from a lot of social media interaction and the recall and things like that. I appreciate that, and I've continued that on. However, getting more door-to-door, going out there, trying to reach the crowd that isn't connected to social media, and that doesn't mean if it's old or new or anything like that, just, you know, life puts you in a certain position where you may not have the time to put into that. So I'd like to reach out to the north end of the city, the south end of the city, east and west. I didn't pay attention to, and it's probably to my detriment, but I didn't pay attention to just voters and to target voters. I wanted to get people talking. I think we have to take people out of their little elements and their little categories and try to talk as a people, try to communicate among each other. Some people aren't from Fall River, but they care about what's going on in Fall River. People in Tiverton, Swansea, Somerset, Westport, they all care about what's going on in the city. They may have some type of investment. They might have family members or people that they care about in this area. So I think it's more important to just reach out to everybody and not just focus on one thing. So what I think has been different is that I've been trying to broaden my message to people and not care about whether they vote or not, but just to try to get a more positive conversation in the city around us.
Have you heard anything that sort of surprised you that you didn't know about, maybe, or that you didn't expect to hear from people?
As far as my campaign goes, more people, I've run into people that I never knew would know who I am. People in, you know, one end of the city, oh, I've seen your signs, I know who you are. Some guys are like, I pay attention to everything you say on Facebook, and, you know, you're doing a good job. And some people say, oh, you know, you could have done this better. But I'm surprised at how much people are, like, in a city where a lot of people say they don't pay attention, and you look at the voting, you look at, you know, some of the numbers, they're really down. But there's still a lot of people out there that care about what's going on in the city. So,
do you think Forever is moving in the right direction?
In some cases, yeah. I like the way that the education department has moved. I like the school committee. Last year's school committee was very good from all of them, not just one or two people, but I liked the entire school committee and the direction that they went. Their meetings were very not just civilized, like, for cordial purposes, but they were productive, and they were, you know, they, not everything's going to always go perfect, and people are going to vote for things you don't like here and there, of course, but I just thought that the agenda of the school committee was for a better school situation, a better school department. And I didn't get that vibe from the city council. From the city council, it was just, you know, constant discord, a lot of self-promotion, some irresponsible voting and some irresponsible situations, especially when it came to the budget. So in some directions, I really do like what's going. But as far as the city council goes, it was tough. And Mayor Jaisal Carrere, as far as he goes, in comparison to Sam Sutter, in comparison to Willa Flanagan, I think he's done a better job than those two. And it's not to be an insult to the other two, it's just to give credit to some of the things that the current mayor has been doing. He's been doing fine in some cases. There's some where, I would disagree with, but no, you're not going to agree with everything the mayor does. But I think his efforts have been to try to promote the city, even though I didn't agree with the Make It Here promotion, but his efforts were to try to promote the city. You see it in the debates. He's the one talking about some of the more positive things that's going on in the city. The opponent has talked about bullets flying all over, you know, the city and everything. So you have a different, you know, situation between the two. And both have valid points, but I think there is a lot more positive going on in the city right now. I think there are some things to be hopeful about.
Do you think Forever is safe?
Safer or safe? No, I think there's some parts of the city that's not safe. I think that there's some situations in the city that aren't safe. And we have a lot more work to do. And I think that the connecting of the people that do, I wrote it in the article where you guys posed the questions. I think I was one of the few, if not the only, that really emphasized the people's role and how we can help our communities be safe. A perfect example is housing. Some of the housing areas in the city, when I, you know, all the candidates go to the high rises and things like that. One of the major concerns from these tenants are the safety of the buildings, safety as far as in Mitchell. They have a walkway where cars are just, they feel like they're flying too fast and they would like to have some safety issues there. But as far as people going in that don't belong in those buildings, there's been all kinds of, I mean, every single high rise and every single housing area I've went to talk to people, it's the same exact message. Safety is an important piece. And I've talked to them about, well, what if we can get a group of people together? Or what if you can, you know, through conversation with public safety officials, have something official down there that can just be a reporting group of people, so that way you can get the police there when you need to. I was given mixed signals that it wasn't allowed, and I, as a city councilor, I would love to be able to bring that table, that conversation to the table. I think that's an important one, because the question specifically was, how can people feel safe? And I think that people are going to feel a lot safer when they're invested in it. I don't want vigilantes running around the city, but again, I say very distinctly, with coordination through the police department, having some type of civilian involvement, community watch, whatever it is, I think those things all help keep our community safe without being too much of a burden on, you know, the rest of the taxpaying population or anything like that.
All right. Any closing thoughts?
Yeah, I think that it's I think that I'm going to be one of the most enthusiastic and productive city councilors that you've seen if you ever vote for me. I will not just sit still and let problems go by me. I am 100% going to be engaged in the community just as much as I've been, and you can compare me to any other city councilor out there. I'm as engaged in the community and engaged in and caring about your rights as much as anyone's ever had been involved in this over the past few years. And I will follow through on that. I only deal in facts. I don't deal in any other kind of way. We will bring all the information out to the table on every subject and make sure that you're getting the best that you deserve as citizens of Fall River.
All right. Thank you very much.